It's May 3rd, and I'm going to start my fourth summer of urine fertilization experiments. Well, this summer is going to be slightly different because I'm not going to be fertilizing anything with urine. Over the past summers, looking at the results from that, I just can't think of a way that this summer I can figure out anything new other than just confirming what I already know, which is, I think, pretty certain, at least anything new with urine. I do think that I can figure out something new with whether or not just the adding the water with the urine, like the water in the urine and then the extra rinse on top of it, has any effect on it. Because that's one thing that I didn't experiment. I didn't do all of a plot with like equal water and urine across all three of them. And I guess I'm still not going to be doing that this year, even though that would be, I think, the ideal setup. What I'm going to be doing this year is just adding water to the plots in a similar manner to how I added urine. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up these plots here. So what I'm going to do this summer is just apply water to these. And for consistency, this water is going to be water from our spring, which is also the water we drink without really any extra treatment. And so on the middle plot, kind of my one that I've done every 12th day on the urine, I'm going to try to apply 2 gallons, which is about 1 watering can. This is actually slightly less, but it'll be good enough every week, about once a week. And then for the plot, that one, the edge plot, which is the equivalent of the urine once every 4 days in the other plots, I'm going to try to apply 5 gallons of water twice a week. And so when I'm applying this, I'm going to try to apply this on a day that it isn't raining and is a fairly dry day, just to try to see, like, if I just apply it on a day that like a ton of rain is falling, like, what effect would it really have? Like, I just don't think that it would have much of an effect because it's already saturated with water. And I'm using the watering can to apply this just so I can get an even spread rather than just like chucking it on. This is probably something I should have done with the urine prior, but I didn't think of it. Thank you. So it's May 17th, and this is Site B, which this year I'm not putting any treatment on. And this is plot number 5, and this is plot number 6. So this had a 1/12th treatment for the past 3 years, and this has had nothing. One every 12 days. So one thing I noticed is that this looks a lot taller than this plot, and this plot is pretty similar to the 1/4th plot. This is the 1/4th plot. It's a little bit denser. But when I actually look at the heights of the reed canary grass in both of them, this one isn't that much higher than the reed canary grass over here. And just there's a lot more of that taller reed canary grass. And this does look higher than some of the other reed canary grass, but it's not too much different, though it is only slightly higher. I just thought this was an interesting note that I think it may have more to do with the species than the height of the grass. So this is a bit higher, definitely. It's June 13th, and I'm going to be cutting down these plots today. Part of the reason I'm cutting them down is that they've grown up enough that I think it's probably a good time to cut them down. So before I cut them down, I'm making some observations, and this is the plot that I've just been adding water to this year. And I think I have some observations, which are the plot with the most water added seems to have considerably more tangleweed than particularly the plot with no water added. And maybe the grass is a little bit taller, and this plot is kind of in between, but more towards the plot with a lot of water, even though I'm only adding like a 10th of an inch of water each time, and I've added less than an inch of water so far on this plot. So I'm not entirely sure. So I am going to cut them down and see how it happens. I think I see these, but I also, it's not like a blind trial. I'm not like trying to read into it. I know what I'm kind of looking for in these. So it's definitely not as clear as what I've seen with the other plots that I've added urine to, which in a way makes sense. So as typical, I'm going to be scything these down. I'm also going to be scything the areas not exactly in the plot. You can also see pretty clearly where I've been trampling down the area to water this plot over here every couple days. And it's like pretty trampled down compared to the rest of the grass. So another observation before I do cutting down is that in Site B plots 4, 5, and 6, high, low, and no fertilization for the past 3 years and not fertilized this year, is that this reed canary grass is still here and pretty tall, and it looks about even between the two of them. As opposed to Site C plot 7, 8, and 9, which also had the heavily fertilized, medium fertilization, or low fertilization, and no fertilization for the past 3 years, and I'm not fertilizing this year. And in this plot, which had big high reed canary grass last year and the previous years even, this grass, there's still tall ones, but there isn't that much reed canary grass. Wouldn't know what's happening, but behind me down here, it is, the reed canary grass is quite tall going down there. Just another interesting note about this site. So after a summer of putting water on these plots twice a week with 5 gallons and once a week at 2 gallons, I can't say I can definitively see a difference. Again, as I was saying at the midsummer update, I think there might be a difference with slightly thicker grass, not really taller grass, but just a thicker grass in this 5 gallon and even somewhat the 2 gallon plot, but I can't definitively say. What I can say is that because there isn't a massive increase, is that the urine is definitely having effect. It isn't just the watering that is causing the massive increase in grass growth that I've observed for the past 3 years. The watering might have a small effect, but really not a really significant in terms of how much increase in grass growth. And of all years to observe a change in this growth in grass due to watering, I would expect to see it this year. We had a very dry late, like second half of May, and through June was pretty dry. There was some rain throughout there. And then this like August and September, it's September 25th today, was also dry. Admittedly, I wasn't watering these through the second half of August and September, but it's been really dry compared to most years. But one of the kind of the interesting things I've noticed is that the grass behind me, for the most part, with the exception of the places that just grass is like dead, like the reed canary grass stalks with some of the leaves starting to dry up, die off, which is normal. It's not due to water stress particularly. Maybe it's happening a bit earlier, but not substantially out of the ordinary. But like the grass is still green, which like in many places when they have water stress, the grass isn't green any longer. And actually earlier this in the May-June period when we were having a lot of dryness as well, even though there was some rain, I did notice some patches of grass drying up, but that came back when we had some rain during July, not a ton, but definitely more typical. I think that might have something to do with our soil here in Vermont. Most of Vermont, and definitely this area, is a pretty, has a lot of clay and silt in it, fines in the soil. So that helps keep water in the soil rather than letting it drain out, which is annoying for other reasons when you're trying to have well-draining soil. But most of kind of the base soil around here is either valley bottom clay or glacial till, both of which have a lot of fines. Unless there's specifically places with deposits of other soil. But when I was saying that, like the June, I also noticed that that June time period, the river, our river was much lower than it is currently. And my theory behind that is it's fall. Like a lot of things aren't using as much water as they were in the early summer, late spring period when there's just massive growth. And so there's just less water being used. So even though we've had way less rain, it's been almost a month since we've had significant rainfall. There just isn't as much water need as there was in June when we were having rain every 2 weeks or so. Not a ton of rain, but way less than normal. And so I think that's maybe why we aren't seeing as much of an effect, is that we just don't need the water as much at this time of year, as opposed to in June. One other aspect that indicates having dry weather is it's September 25th and the trees are changing colors, and they have been for a week and a half, 2 weeks already, and this is really early. I'd say beginning of October, the first 2 weeks of October is when I'd normally expect trees, leaves to start changing colors. And so this has been a really early year, and they have color changes earlier when it's drier, and so that's another indication of that it is dry this year.
To analytically show that it has been dry, I was able to acquire local rainfall data, shown here with the amount of water applied during heavy and frequent application on top and marked in orange. With a cumulative rainfall graph over these 4 months, it is easy to see how this summer had below average rainfall, though not as far below as I was expecting, especially considering it is pretty close to average when I stopped adding water to the plots. At the end of my adding water, I had added about 50% more water than natural with the high addition of water, while only 10% more with the low added water.
So looking at the plots where I didn't do anything this year, just observed it and cut the grass, I can't say with definitive about like how well they grew compared to last year, because, well, I cut the grass at different times, photos were taken at different times, just weather was different this year compared to last year. So I can't say that they perform worse this year than last year because they weren't having urine applied, but the plots where urine was applied last year, B, C, and this one, E, there is definitely a distinction to where urine was applied and where it wasn't. I can't say that there's like a really a discernible difference between like the high fertilization and the medium fertilization, though in both this one E and B, it seems to kind of be low grass, like, creeping into part of it, and then it comes higher grass partway through. I don't know if that is part of the effect of the urine fertilization. I'm not really sure. But what I can say is that this effect, at least with how grass is growing, lasts more than 1 year. I guess I'll just have to see how these proceed through next year as well.